Welcome to the RSS tutorial. In this short video, we are going to cover a topic that is very important in helping you stay up to date on the latest developments in a field, as well as virtually any internet content that you need to stay informed on. What website technology is capable of doing this? RSS. RSS, or really simple syndication, is an easy way for you to keep up with news and information that's important to you, and helps you avoid the conventional methods of browsing or searching for information on individual websites, blogs, and databases. Now the content you want can be delivered directly to you without cluttering your inbox with email messages. This content is called a feed. You may have noticed this symbol on websites that you frequent for research or for leisure, or you may have noticed any of these other symbols. All of these indicate that an RSS feed is available for that particular website. Instead of having to constantly check a website to see if anything new is going on and maybe missing some important information, you can subscribe to the RSS feed, and any new content will be delivered right to you. The new content is delivered to what is called an RSS reader. This is a program that will consolidate all of the feeds that you have signed up for, so you can just go to one spot to see updates and new content from as many different sites as you like. There are many different RSS readers to choose from, and most are available at no cost. The looks and features for each may differ, but the basic idea behind them remains the same. This video will use Feedly as an example because this is a free and easy to use reader. To create a Feedly account, go to www.feedly.com and click the Get Started button. Feedly will now prompt you to create an account. If you have a Google or Facebook account, simply click the corresponding button and use your account credentials to sign up for Feedly. Otherwise, click the Continue with Feedly button to begin the registration process. When finished registering, check your inbox for a confirmation message and to verify your email address. Once logged in, click Add Content, then Publications and Blogs to begin discovering content. You can now add content by searching for a URL, title, or topic. Alternatively, you can explore the web by browsing any of the topics displayed on Feedly's homepage. Let's add a feed to our Feedly account. We will try searching for a topic. If searching for a topic, type a topic preceded by a hashtag into the search bar. Your results page will display RSS feeds for sites to which you can subscribe. Click on the title of any result to see a description and the most recent feeds for that particular RSS feed. If you like what you are seeing from the most recent feeds displayed, you can add it to your Feedly account by clicking on the Follow button. A drop-down will display, and you can now choose how to categorize this feed. You can read an entire post right from your RSS reader by clicking on the title of the post. Or you can click Visit Website to go directly to the post's native site. Now we will go over how to add RSS feeds to journals you discover through Roadrunner search. This will be useful if you have identified a particular journal that publishes relevant information to your research topic and you would like to know the contents of each new issue that is published. Once you have identified a resource of interest to you, click on the result to access the record information. Pay attention to the source title and click on the hyperlinked publication name to go to the full publication record. From the publication record, click on the share link in the upper right-hand corner of the page. Next, click on the RSS feed button. Copy the link listed under the RSS feed heading. And paste the URL into Feedly's Add Content box. Now there is one very crucial step you will need to do prior to clicking Enter on your keyboard to execute the search. You will have to remove the text .proxy1.ncu.edu from the URL in order for the RSS feed to work properly. After removing, click Enter on your keyboard to execute.
You should see one result featuring the journal title. Click the Follow button to add it to your Feedly account.
You can also add an RSS feed for any search query you conduct in Roadrunner Search. Your RSS feed will be updated anytime a new resource is added to our library databases, which matches your search request. Now there's no need to run the same search time and time again in hopes of seeing the latest related research. Your RSS feed will do all of the work for you and make sure you stay up to date with the latest information in your research area.
The setup process is identical to adding an RSS feed for a particular journal. Click on the Share link on the right-hand side of the page and select the RSS feed text box. Copy the RSS feed link and then you will paste it into Feedly's Add Content box. Don't forget to remove the text .proxy1.ncu.edu from the URL in order for the RSS feed to work properly. After removing, click Enter on your keyboard to execute.
Additionally, you can add any websites or blogs relevant to your research or personal interests to your RSS reader. You may need to browse around the site in order to locate the RSS feed button or URL. Alternatively, you can search by the blog's or website's title directly in Feedly. We hope you enjoy using RSS feeds, and remember to contact the library if you have any questions.